Today we will discuss the chapter landscape of the soul. In this chapter, I would like to discuss the expression used in the chapter. Expression used in the chapter. Phrases used in the chapter. Used in the chapter. And difficult words. Difficult words used in the chapter. So in this chapter, we are going to discuss expressions, phrases, and difficult words used in the chapter. They will help us to understand the chapter very well, because expressions, phrases, and difficult words have contextual meaning. Apart from this, we will discuss the summary of the chapter.
Let us understand the contextual meaning of the expressions used in the chapter, The Landscape of the Soul. Take the first two paragraphs of this chapter. Landscape. A landscape is the visible features of an area of land, its landforms integrating with natural or man-made features. Next word is commissioned. It means ordered, or to ask or an artist, writer, etc. to do a piece of work. Immense sky means vast sky, limitless sky. At the foot of the mountain, it means very bottom of a mountain. Dwells, lives or stays. Splendid, grand. Beyond anything words can convey. Beyond expression. Ineffable ideas or emotions that are difficult to put into words. Astonished, taken by surprise. Classical education, tradition of education that emphasizes seeking after of truth, goodness and beauty, and the study of liberal arts. Anecdote, story, a short account of a particular incident or event, especially of an interesting or exciting nature. Flanders, a medieval country in Western Europe. Now, we will understand the expressions used in the third, fourth, and fifth paragraph of the chapter Landscape of the Soul. Delicate realism. Alluring quality of the art which makes it seem real, or to make something look real. Illusionistic likeness, a similarity which creates illusion, or refers to an illusion created by the semblance of something, or you can say refers the technique of using pictorial methods in order to deceive the eyes. Swat, hit or crush something, give a hard blow. Apprentice, training. Essence of inner life and spirit. It means essence of spiritual and divine life. Outer appearance, external appearance or physical appearance. Mysterious work of universe. Puzzling work, inexplicable work, or magical work of the universe that is full of wonder and curiosity. Beyond any material appearance means beyond physical or visual appearance. Not meant to reproduce an actual view. It means not made with a real viewpoint, but is a representation of artist thought. Figurative painting refers to the metaphoric representation of a piece of art through the eyes of creator's imagination. Leisurely movement, relaxed movement. Horizontal scroll, scrolls on which one paints in such a manner that as the scroll is unrolled, more elements continue to get added to the painting. Conceptual space refers to relation with abstract than factual representation. Now we will learn about the expressions or words used in 6th and 7th paragraph and in the additional part of the chapter. Sanshui, it means mountain water. Complementary, together making up a whole. Conduit, it means channel. Reflecting means explaining. Interaction, it means union. Receptive, it means open and responsive to ideas, impressions or suggestion, fit to receive and transmit stimuli. Feminine aspect of universal energy, it means feminine qualities, traits, part, feature of universal energy. Counterpart, it means opposite, equivalent, match or parallel. Fundamental notion, basic idea or belief. Middle void, the third element where there is interaction between yang and yin, or you can say blank space between the sky and the earth. Suspension of breath, it means relaxing the respiratory organ for the constant motion of breath. Conduit of communication, channel of communication. Oppressed by the lofty peaks means suppressed due to high peaks or burdened with high mountain. Art brute, works of art in their raw state. Minority interest, an activity or subject that is of interest to only a limited number of people. Wheeled beginnings, the beginnings that are not directly expressed. Outsider art, it refers to the art produced by untrained artist or self-taught art. Contemporary, of the present time. Stimulating contrast, it means to excite, spark, recreate, distinction or variation. Mainstream offerings, artwork produced by majority of people. Propounding, it means suggesting an idea, explanation or opinion to offer for discussion. Untutored genius, it has two meanings: genius without formal education or instruction, or genius lacking sophistication. Outstanding testimony, it means excellent evidence or declaration. Exposition, it means elucidation, interpretation, presentation, explication. यहाँ पर हमने जितने भी words किए हैं, ये इनके जो meanings हैं, इनका जो explanation था वो contextual था, chapter के according था. Next part में हम इस चैप्टर को समझने की कोशिश करेंगे।